Good evening. I'm going to show you how to cash out your crypto from your Trust Wallet app into your bank account. There are a couple of different options. There is one that I prefer just because it has lower fees. And the last step's the tricky one, so make sure you get that step correct. The first thing you need to do is swap any of your crypto into a sellable coin. So I'll show you a couple of examples here. If I click on BNB, the Binance coin, that is a major coin, and you'll see that there is a sell icon available here on the right hand side, and I can choose to sell that directly. But if I go to one of the smaller coins, such as Pit or Cake, just as an example, you'll see that the sell icon does not exist in either one of those. You cannot sell directly on Trust Wallet. So therefore, if you want to sell one of the smaller coins, the first thing you're going to have to do is a swap. So I'm going to use the Pancake coins that I have as an example here. So if I tap on that, you'll see that there is an option available to swap. What you want to do is swap that coin into a major coin. And Cake operates on the Binance BNB network. So what I'm going to do is swap those coins for BNB. You can then look at the fees. There'll be a small slippage. It's going through an approval step, and I'll just confirm the swap now. You'll be able to see the network fee. If the amount you're swapping is bigger than I am, it'll obviously be a much smaller percentage. I'm just doing this as an example. Okay, I'll just confirm that. And that is processing. So let's give that a few seconds, and I should see that execute, and you can see the notification there that smart contract has executed. So now that's step one done. Step two, you've got the option of selling on Trust Wallet or transferring coins to an exchange. Let's start with the first. If I go to Binance and if I go to sell, I've got the option of selling with Ramp. What is Ramp? It's just a exchange provider which allows you to swap crypto for currency. However, the problem is, I'm not going to continue these steps, but you can if you want, you can sell directly. The problem with this option is the fees. I've seen about 10% fees. So if I'm swapping, say, $100 of coins, I'll get charged around $10 worth in fees. And frankly, I think that's a bit of a ripoff. Although it's really easy, you do pay for that convenience. But I'm going to show you an easier way, or a more cost-effective way, and that is transferring the coins to an exchange. I'm going to use Coinbase as my example. Other exchanges are Kraken or Binance. They're very popular, massive exchanges that people use every day. I'm sure you know about them. What we want to do is receive those coins in the exchange from your Trust Wallet. So in this example, let's go to BNB on the exchange. I'm then going to, actually, this is a really good sticking point. Binance doesn't actually allow BNB to be tradable. So that's a bit of a blocker. We cannot transfer the Binance to Coinbase and then exchange, withdraw for cash. Binance, on the other hand, does allow BNB coin, by virtue of its name, to be tradable on the Binance exchange, which you then can withdraw. So this is actually a really perfect example of a situation you might see yourself in. So what do you then do? You're going to have to do a cross-chain transfer if the exchange that you're using doesn't support the coin that you want to send to it. So I've just pressed swap, and I'm going to do a cross-chain transfer. I know for a fact that Coinbase, as well as Binance and Kraken and all the other exchanges, do support Ethereum, right? So because I've got BNB coin, I'm going to have to do a cross-chain swap into Ethereum, which I'm then going to send into my exchange and then withdraw as cash. So let's do that. So back on the app, I'm going to exchange the Binance BNB for Ethereum. We'll confirm that, and that's processing. The Ethereum swap will take a little longer, so just wait a few minutes. I'll come back in a sec. You can see the notification, the smart contract is being executed. I can see the Ethereum in my account. Now we're back on track again, because I can receive Ethereum in my Coinbase, and therefore I'm going to, in the app, send Ethereum. And in my exchange, in the right-hand side over here, I'm going to receive Ethereum. That receive has generated an address, and I'm now going to click on, you've got a couple of ways. You can copy this address, somehow email it to yourself and copy and paste into this field here, or you can click this little icon on the right-hand side on your mobile and scan the QR code, which I've done there, and there's less chance of error that way. Enter the amount. I've just clicked max. Now when I click next, it's going to send the Ethereum from the Trust Wallet into this receiving address. I'll confirm, and it's processing. So let's again give it a couple of minutes. I'll come back and refresh my exchange account on the right-hand side here. I've done a refresh, and as you can see, the Ethereum has now landed into this exchange account on Coinbase. That's step two done. Now for the third and final step, which is selling and cashing out. First, I'm gonna go and sell my Ethereum. So go into the asset that you want to sell. I want to sell just up here for currency. So sell, I've got this much Ethereum available, and you can enter the amount that you want to sell. So let's do that, and I'll review that order. You can also view the fees if you would like to. What that does is then hold cash in your exchange. That's done, that part was really easy. It's the last part here that people get a little bit stuck on, and that is the withdrawal into your bank account. The reason is, if I press withdraw now, I've got the ability to cash out, right? So if I put, you can see the balance here, right? After doing that transaction. So if I withdraw, you'll see there are a couple of bank accounts that I have available to send my withdrawal to. If you don't have that, the reason is that you first need to make a deposit into your exchange account. The only reason I have these bank accounts available is because I've made a deposit previously to this exchange, and that's the way for the exchange to validate and connect your bank account. So even if it's a $5 deposit or $10 deposit, click on that. You can use PayID or BSB with Coinbase at least. In Binance and Kraken, it might be slightly different, but it's the exact same process. And that will activate those bank accounts to, in the future, be able to withdraw that money. So I will cash it out, and I'll show you the rest of the process. I'll select the bank account, and I'll continue. And I've already received a notification. My cash has landed, and that completes our tutorial. If you have any questions, please do ask in the comments. Let's help each other, because crypto can be a little bit confusing at times. Give it a thumbs up, like it, and subscribe. See you next time.